If Fred Jones had his way years ago, the Southern Heritage Classic would have been centered around a music festival instead of a football game. But he could never get that idea to work out. So out of one failed idea, a greater one was born.
It started with the football game. My idea was to put something around the football game, but it is kind of taken off.
Fred Jones, founder of the Southern Heritage Classic, tells us the classic is now more about what happens on and off the football field. There are multiple concerts, a fashion show, a golf tournament, parade, and a college fair. But at the beginning, Jones describes a doubt from sports fans.
They would say, this is not just a football game. You know, if it wasn't for the entertainment, if it wasn't for all of that, then people would not be involved. Well, guess what? Everything today is entertainment.
Jones honed his event planning skills while working on the road with Isaac Hayes, who was a regular customer at the bank where Jones was an assistant manager.
Shaft broke big in 71 and said, you know, we're going on tour, we need somebody to count money. This was a special moment.
He worked as a road manager and promoter. That background helped shape what we know today as the Southern Heritage Classic.
Put a plan together and then execute that plan. And I think that's the reason why we've been able to get started, and that's the reason why we're celebrating 30 years.
The Classic faced a major obstacle when it was forced to share its big day with the University of Memphis football team, leading to a doubleheader at the Liberty Bowl, a logistical nightmare. The Memphis Tigers played Mississippi State in the afternoon. Jackson State and Tennessee State had to wait until that night, upsetting many Classic fans, including his mother.
I went to see her. And you know, she was cooking, and she just got real emotional. She said, we only want to play one day, and they want to take it from us.
Us. Jones says that's what's special about the Classic. It doesn't belong to one person. It belongs to the longtime community supporters. The love for the Classic was evident again last year when an impending storm forced Jones to cancel the big game minutes before kickoff.
The only thing you hear people talking about now is that, man, I hope they don't rain on our game this year. On our game. On our event.
Jones is praying for better weather this year. There's now a contractual agreement in place preventing doubleheaders, and the football game is now secured through 2024.
Somebody might want to ask, well, how long are you going to do it? Well, you know what? I never would have thought I'd been doing it this long. But I got 375,000 miles on my car. I never thought I was going to be driving it that long.
Jones's son helps him run the Classic, and about 30 of his staff members have been with him all 30 years. Jones credits the success of the Southern Heritage Classic to a team effort. Not the one that actually plays ball, but the team that keeps the ball rolling.